So we get our first Shams bomb of the offseason, and Mike Conley is traded to the Utah Jazz for Grayson Allen, Jay Crowder, Kyle Korver, pick 23 in the draft, and a future protected pick. So what is going on, everybody? Welcome back here today to another NBA 2K19 trade video. Now, I plan on doing two different videos today. Not a double upload, but first I plan on doing a D-Lo video yesterday. Recorded it, had it, let him sign with the Pacers, did a rebuild there. Then Celtics news broke out on how Al Horford wants out. He's getting a four-year, $100 million contract from somebody else, possibly. Don't know who that is. Maybe it's the Kings. Maybe it's the Mavs. Maybe it's the Bucks. But then this news dropped, and I really wanted to do a rebuild surrounding Mike Conley. So here we are on 2K19 with the Utah Jazz. I just completed the trade on 2K19, and I know people ask, like, all the time, how do you do this in, like, without player options and happening? I just go into the only person in this trade that had an option was Kyle Korver's team option. So I went into it, got rid of the team option, just gave him $7 million and made the trade. Now, saved it, and here we are before staff signing. So here we are with the Utah Jazz. Obviously, we don't need to worry about our coach at all. Always got to pick up a better trainer so we get those training camps. Now, for free agency, I know there was some ties to Tobias Harris come free agency time, which I would love. But our assistant GM didn't want to sign with us. That kind of hurts. All right, so I'm just going to sign a one-year deal with this guy and hope there's better options next offseason. But yeah, like I was saying, I know that there was Tobias Harris rumors, but now I don't know if that leaves them with any cap to go after somebody in that caliber. What I might try to do is move Dante Exum for a first-round pick because it is a $9 million salary. We could try to go after Tobias Harris if we do clear up that cap space, but if not, we might just have to fall back on an in-house option and bring back Derek Favors. So what could I get for Exum? If I can maybe package Exum in my 23rd pick for a first, I might do that. Maybe the Spurs are interested in getting a foreign point guard. All right, so the Spurs do have two first-round picks. I don't think I can get 19. Actually, maybe I can get 19 for Exum in 23. They want a future second, and they'll give me Metu. I don't even want Metu. So I'll agree to that, and we have the 19th pick in the draft. I'll see you guys at rookie signings with who I draft. All right, so the player I drafted, wow. What is this draft order? The Grizzlies don't take Ja Morant now that they don't have Mike Conley. They take DeAndre Hunter. Oh, my God. Knicks take Culver. Pelicans leave. Oh, my God. Ja goes 5 to the Cavs, and RJ is going to fall to 8 to the... Wow. Okay, whatever. But the guy I ended up drafting at pick 19 was Romeo Langford, and he... is going to possibly be a G League guy next year. I don't know, 74 overall. I could have went need-based and took, like, a Grant Williams, but I decided to go kind of BPA. I don't know if he's even better than Grant Williams, but all right, so now we have an option here. Do we want to bring back Derek Favors on a team option? You know what? I might, and then see if we can maybe still get Tobias Harris, not with Derek Favors, but maybe I can move Derek Favors for a pick or something. So we'll see what happens with that. So free agency time. Tobias Harris has one offer from the Bucks. Interesting. He doesn't even fit our system that well. We would be 13 mil off. Wow, there is a possible way. So I could afford him if I did move Favors. I could just move Exum and... Oh, wait. I didn't throw Grayson in that trade? Damn it, I'm stupid. Sorry. All right, let me do that real quick. Let me just send Grayson Allen to the Grizzlies for their second round pick in 2022, and I will also give you my second round pick in 2022. Completely forgot to do that. All right, so if we're going to throw up Derek Favors here in the trade finder, we could look for a small forward, bring back Jay Crowder. Interesting. Not really great offers for Derek Favors, but I think to get over, like, to make a title push, that would be huge to get Tobias Harris. We can get Caruso from the Nets. Cheap option here. Favors would be a free agent next offseason, so if we strike out on Tobias Harris, we could just take a one-year rental, maybe Paul Millsap, something like that. So, I mean, Blake Griffin would be cool, like, to try to package that, but I just don't think we have the future assets, just giving up another future first in the Mike Conley trade. All right, so I'm going to actually do that next trade. We're going to get Caruso. Do I get a first out of this? No, we get a second, but we are going to save 15 mil with that trade. Now, like I said, I'm going to go all out for Tobias Harris, give him that player option, no trade clause. Hopefully, he likes that over the Bucks fan. I know he's not a fit, but let's just see. Yes. That's actually a pretty steal, like, big steal for Tobias, who was a borderline all-star last year. So out of our free agents, like, Rubio's not coming back. Thabo maybe on a minimum, but we do get Tobias Harris, which is huge. Wow, Ricky Rubio had a huge cap hold. All right, cap it. So I'm liking that. So our starting five is going to be Conley, Mitchell, Ingles, Tobias, Gobert, that's nice as hell. All right, so looking in the affordable section, we could try to bring in a Tony Allen or an Avery Bradley. I guess the Grizzlies didn't bring back Avery Bradley. I think he had a team option or something like that. So I wouldn't mind that, and then that could force us to send Romeo Langford to the G League. So I'll do a tier deal on that, and then we can move him for maybe a center next offseason. So please sign with me. Oh, no. Okay, no, we do get him. Now, I would like to see if there's a better option than Tony Bradley here. Okay, not really looking too good, but could I possibly move Tony Bradley for a better backup center? I doubt it. Yeah, I could just really get a second round pick. You know what? I'm actually going to take that from the Suns. So I know I'm trading my UNC boy, but we are going to go back here to free agency. And wait, I can bring back Rubio still? Yo, I have to do this. All right, so we're going to offer Rubio a 3-year deal, 30 mil, because I just can. So thank you. And then a backup center, Al Jefferson. We'll get Yafrio Vern because he's only 27, so he won't really regress just yet. So we'll renounce that. Okay, cool. So now if we look at our team is looking nice. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Langford will be in the G League. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We're ready for next year. And with the West being wide open, I mean, I'm hoping KD didn't re-sign with the Warriors. Please tell me he didn't. Please. Okay, all right, so the West is technically wide open, even though Klay will be playing next year. All right, so while I send some guys out to have potential, like Caruso, like Mitchell, and like Langford, I do want to talk about this trade. So usually when trades happen, especially big trades like this, when an all-star player is getting moved, people love to throw out winners and losers of a trade, right? But I think in this case, even I think like the Lakers trade, I think both teams were winners with the AD trade. In this case, I think both teams were winners, and I think both teams will be winners in 5 years. I think, like, no team will ever lose this trade for two reasons. Unless Mike Conley obviously, like, gets a catastrophic injury, which I pray doesn't happen because you guys know how much I love Mike Conley. I don't know if he's really underrated anymore because so many people, I mean, I still think he was underrated in Memphis because nobody talked about him, and he should have at least, like, 4 All-Stars under his belt, but he played in a pretty impressive conference. But the Grizzlies side of things, they unloaded the $30 million contract of Conley. Ja Morant is kind of solidifies they're going to draft Ja Morant. He can get 30, 34 minutes a game, play him, Jaren Jackson Jr., the two focal points of that rebuild, and they also get the 23rd pick, so they can add another rookie in this draft, which is nice. Two, they're going to be even worse next year without Conley because their pick is top 6 protected. So they need to be one of the top 6 picks to keep it or go to Boston. So they're going to be worse. And then they get a future pick. Maybe the Jazz will be bad that year. Or maybe it'll be like the 18th pick, something nice to add along with another first they will have that year. So that's something nice. More draft capital never hurts. And then the Jazz, they get an all-star point guard where they can now bring back Derek Favors because I believe if they wanted to go after like a D'Angelo Russell or a Kemba Walker or even a Kyrie Irving, they would have had to let Derek Favors walk. So in this case, they can sign Derek Favors back or maybe create a little bit more cap space if they are able to unload maybe Exum's deal to go after like a Tobias Harris, something like that. So yeah, especially with the Warriors not going to be pretty much title contenders next year, at least we think. The West is wide open. I love this trade for the Jazz. Conley and Mitchell, I think, can complement each other pretty well. And very nice defensive backcourt with Gobert. They're going to be one of the better defensive teams in the league next year, especially with Ingles and stuff like that, and maybe Exum coming off the bench still. And yeah, I literally like this. Like I said, the West is going to be wide open. You're going to have teams like the Rockets, Lakers, Trailblazers, Nuggets, Jazz, Spurs, Warriors, all going to be in contention for the finals. And I think this is a great move for both teams. All right, guys, so this is how the team is going to look like for next year's season. We do have Conley and Mitchell both getting 35, Ingles getting 31, Tobias getting 35, and Gobert getting 33. And then Rubio, Bradley, Caruso, and Laverne will make up the bench, the four-man bench. Scoring options, I thought about going like Mitchell, Harris, Conley. You know what? I'll see what that does for season number one, and if I don't really like it, I'll change it for next year's season. So this is going to be the starting five. This is for defense. That's why Harris didn't really fit it well. But if we go to balanced, it fits a lot better. So I'm going to end up changing Quinn Snyder's thing to balanced. I could also do perimeter-centric, but I'll keep it at balanced. And then our preseason power ranking for this upcoming season is going to be 12 according to NBA.com. 2K Sports is going to have us also at 12. And are we going to be 12 by Mark Spears as well? No, 13. He couldn't keep the trend. So yeah, that'll be for me. I'll see you guys at the end. I don't know why I thought I was ending the video there. What? But yeah, that'll be for me for now. And I'll see you guys at the end of season number one. All right, guys. So we finished the 2019-20 season with a 45-37 record. So solid. Was hoping we would be mid to high 50s, honestly. So we're going to see who was maybe bad and who we maybe need to upgrade from in the offseason. So Zion gets Rookie of the Year. You saw Jokic got MVP. Then Schroeder in Phoenix six man. I wonder who's starting for them. Well, they traded for a midseason. Giannis Defensive Player of the Year. Most Improved to Aiden. So the Suns doing the Winning Every Award Challenge. And D'Antoni Coach of the Year. So no Jazz here on the All-NBA teams. But we do get Gobert, an All-Defensive First Team, who I did give a pretty big contract extension to that I'll show you guys right now. Yeah, he's going to be here until he's 31 years old. I know in real life, I think he might be eligible for the Supermax next year or something. Where he can make like $55 million in a season, which I don't think the Jazz would ever offer. I don't think any player is really worth $55 million unless his name was like 2015 or 14, 13 LeBron James. Honestly, I don't even think, maybe you would give $55 million to Giannis right now. I don't even know, man. All right, so we are the 6th seed in the Western Conference. Take on the Clippers in round one. Okay, the Clippers got Shea. They got KD. Okay. All right, we're probably not going to beat the Clippers. If we go over to our stats for this year, though, we could see that Donovan Mitchell was pretty solid. So was Tobias Harris. Yeah, and having our best player making $3 million a year is just amazing. Only 3 assists, was hoping that would be a little bit higher, but Conley played really well at the age 32. I tried to see if I can give him a contract extension, but he was undecided. He does have a $34 million team option. I'm debating if I want to pick that up or not, or just decline it and then re-sign him. So we'll think about that when we get there. Gobert was a stud, 15 rebounds a game, 2.8 blocks. Rubio, not bad. Ingles, maybe the guy we need to upgrade in the offseason. He does have $10 million on his contract. 37% from 3, which is good, but we'll see. We'll keep an eye on that. Karuk's not bad, but maybe he should upgrade that. Bradley, not really that good. There's LaVerne, but we do have Romeo Langford, who's a 76 right now. He might be even higher. Yeah, he'll be an 80 next year, so he might be probably be our 6th man. All right, so round one here against the LA Clippers. Can we not get swept? That's all I asked for. 2-0. All right, we're probably gonna get swept. Nope, can we force a game 6? All right, I'll take it. We do lose in 6, but you know what, we put up a little bit of a fight. Let's just see who had good playoff numbers, and then we'll get here into the offseason. Mitchell didn't really shoot great from 3. Obviously his percentages went down. Okay, Tobias played particularly well. Gobert was really good. Conley didn't play the greatest, didn't really shoot well. All right, so the Philadelphia 76ers won it all. Did they sign somebody else in replace of Tobias? Yeah, Julius Randle. Good for them. All right, so we'll get here into the offseason. So the draft lottery, are we going to have our first this year? We should. Grizzlies are at 5. Lucky that they barely get to keep their pick. We are picking. Where are we? 21. All right. So not amazing, but you know what? It's still a pick. Let's definitely try to pick up a better assistant GM. Ryan Johnson would do the trick. William James, we could definitely fire and try to pick up. Vince Carter's ratings aren't that good. Owen Taylor's are not terrible. All right, so NBA draft night. I might see what I could get if I packaged Joe Ingles, Avery Bradley, and the 21st pick in the draft. Jermichael Green, okay, Tristan Thompson, and Larry Nance Jr. Definitely some interesting options. Coley Stein, Alan Crabb, and DeAndre Jordan, Justice Winslow. Wow, we would, like, that's an upgrade. Like, Ingles is solid defensively, and then adding Winslow to that, that's pretty insane, honestly. Brandon Clark, a young option, but we do have Tobias. Steven Adams, obviously I don't need a center. I'm looking for a 3. Ooh, I like Rocco. I do like Rocco adding to this team. So you know what? Do I have to give up my first, though, is the thing. Can I just do Ingles and Bradley for Rocco? They really want my first. I don't want to give up my first is the thing. I will also give you Joffrey LaVerne. Okay, they can't afford that. I will give you my first in 2024. Okay, so they agree to that. I think that's an upgrade, Rocco, over Joe Ingles. So we have the, whatever, 21st pick in the draft. I'll see you guys at Rookie Signings with who I draft. Hopefully somebody falls to me. All right, so I'm pretty happy with who fell to me. His name is Josh Green out of, Kansas? No, Arizona. 74 overall, he's a 2. Could be in the G League. And we got Alpha Diallo. Only drafted him because he's an alpha, you know. And then team player options, we are going to bring back Conley. You know what, we're not going to be free agency destinations anyway. I'll just bring back Conley. Hopefully he wants to sign midseason. And then qualifying offers, we have none. And then let me just see. I might try to move Joffrey LaVerne. But if we do have some option here to sign a better center than LaVerne, okay. Who fits our team well? Nerlens Noel. Okay, can I get Nerlens Noel on a year? Let me just make sure I got nobody else. Damn, AD is a free agent. Probably going to go back to the Lakers, though. So we get Nerlens Noel. Very nice. Okay, so I'm going to move Joffrey LaVerne and in a second to the Suns here. Oh, I did want to see who was the starting point guard for the Suns this year, because Schroeder was their backup. Oh, they got Kobe White. Good for them. Oh, also, I don't think I said it in this video. I do have my mock draft dropping tomorrow, my official final mock draft. It will be dropping hopefully earlier in the day, like around noon or 1 o'clock. Hopefully, I'm going to finish that tonight. And then, yeah, so I just want to let you guys know that's going to be tomorrow's video leading up to the draft, which is tomorrow night. I am hyped. I love the draft more than some other people. It's fun knowing kind of like just rookies getting drafted, teams, draft night trades, all the salary cap implications or complications, whatever. Yeah, I think it's really cool. So I'm very excited about the draft being tomorrow night. All right, guys. So untapped potential, definitely going to send Langford. I'll probably send Josh Green. And then I don't know if Donovan Mitchell was an A plus, but we could probably send him. I'd rather send it to him again over Karuk. So damn, he's not an A plus. That hurts a little. Okay, guys. So here's how the rotation is going to look. We got 35 to the big three offensive guys in Conley, Mitchell, and Harris. Gobert's getting 32, 29 to Robert Covington, and then 24 to Langford as our sixth man, 19 to Rubio, 17 to Noel, and then 14 to Karuk's. Josh Green will be in the G League. System proficiency is 4-star balance. Not bad whatsoever. Covington holds it down a little bit. Even adding Langford doesn't change it. So that is whatever. I do want to see if Conley will come back. Damn, still undecided, but you know I'm going to try to do that mid-season. And then our preseason power ranking, NBA.com. Damn, not even number 15. That hurts. 2K Sports has us at 14, and then Mark Spears has us at 15. So we'll see how we do this year. Hopefully, we can get out of round one. All right, guys, so we finish up the 2020-21 regular season with a bang. We go 57-25. That's kind of what I expected last year, but I'll definitely take that this year. So I did not mention that this trade also has pretty big implications on where D'Lo might end up. I really thought the Jazz were going to be pretty big front runners for D'Lo if he were to hit unrestricted free agency. But now, that eliminates that. Now, if D'Lo wants to win, is really the only viable option Indiana for him? Possibly, or maybe Boston, I don't know. Because there seems like Phoenix, but I think they need to create cap space. Obviously, Orlando might be interested. I don't know if they would have the cap space, and maybe the Knicks would be interested. But I don't know if D'Lo wants to play in a big city. He wants to get paid. He wants to win. I don't really know what he wants to do. So, I just thought the Utah Jazz would have been pretty big favorites for D'Lo if he were to hit unrestricted free agency. So, let's see if we get any All-NBA awards. That would be cool if Mitchell or Gobert maybe got on one of these. Damn, Gobert didn't get any. That sucks. I can't believe Jazz a Cav. Unbelievable. No Jazz on all-defensive first team. We do get Gobert and Robert Covington on all-defensive second team. We were probably like the best defensive team in the league. So, we end the season as a 2-seed. Not bad. We take on Zion in round one. That will be definitely interesting. But we avoid Kevin Durant. We avoid James Harden and Jokic. So we just got to get out of round one. And then I think we can definitely beat Sacramento or Minnesota. Now we check out the... Oh, that is playoff stats. I was about to say nobody scored this year. What? All right. So Mitchell, 21.7 points a game. 3.5 rebounds. 3.5 assists. 1.3 steals a game. Shot really well from the field. I'll take that season from Spida. Tobias Harris, about 20 points. 7.8 rebounds. 3.2 assists. 50... Almost 40, almost 90. I can't say much about that. That's really good. Conley didn't want to re-sign. He wanted to test free agency. So we'll definitely have to keep an eye on that if we don't win at all. 17 points, 8.5 assists, 1.1 steals, good shooting percentages. Langford, pretty solid six-man numbers. Would have been really good in his per 36. And then there's Gobert's numbers doing what he does. Rocco, Rubio, Karuk's, and Noel. Didn't realize that all we have one... 2, 3, 4, 5 players on this team whose first letter starts with R, and three of the four are on the bench. So that's kind of funny. Just no one in the world didn't do that. Should have signed a big man. I could have put Gobert on the bench. I don't know why I'm really caring about that too much. So team stats, points per game. We were 6th. Not bad. Allowed. Oh, we were 2nd. Damn. Shout out to Philly. I thought that said Andrew for a second. I was like, him and Butler again. Damn. Point differential, we were 3rd. All right. Please let me get past the 40 and 42 Zion-led Pelicans. Please, please. All right, we're up 2-0. Just go up 3-0. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Let's just sweep them. Let's go. Make light work of them. We're moving on. No more KD in these playoffs. Love to see that. And we're taking on the 6-seeded Timberwolves. All right, let's see who they have. Also, I would really like to see Al Horford go to the Kings. Don't know where he's going to go, but really would like to see that. So the Timberwolves got Ayo Dosunmu. Definitely butchered that. Old friend Avery Bradley. Paul Zipser. What? Yo, all right, we should sweep this team. We should sweep this team. I was expecting like another all-star with Towns. No, we should definitely sweep this team. All right, 1-1. Don't go down. Oh my god, no way. How are we down 3-1? What the hell? What the hell? All right, game one, we blow them out, looking really well. Game two, Oh my god, how? Towns goes off. Wiggins is coming off the goddamn bench. They're starting freaking Paul Zipser. Game 3, we lose by 9. Huh. Kizio Paul drops 28. You're kidding me. Wiggins drops 23. And game 5, oh, Paul drops 33. Oh, that was our chance, man. Oh, come on. All right, so the Rockets win it all. They beat the Knicks in 7. Who did the Knicks have? They brought back Enes Kanter. They have Chris Middleton, Isaiah Stewart, Jared Culver. Wow. That team made the finals. What? I don't even know. All right, so draft lottery. I don't even know if we have our first round pick. I think it's top 10 protected to the Grizzlies at this point. Yeah, it goes 28 to the Grizzlies, so that's not our problem now. Steph signing. Do I bring in, like, Nick Nurse? I'm going to offer Nick Nurse a deal, but I'm going to definitely offer Quinn Snyder a deal to come back if I could find him. Damn, is he really low, Quinn Snyder? Where's he at? Okay, we're not going to get Nick Nurse, but I'll definitely bring back Quinn Snyder. I hope he can get me to the, like, ugh. Maybe I should have fired him after that abysmal freaking playoff performance. All right, so we don't have anything to really work with here. I might just run the team back, if we're being honest. Maybe get rid of Karuks. Let Josh Green get those minutes. So let me just make sure I got no, like, rookie signings to deal with. Emmett Williams, sure. He's a 68. So we'll bring back all these guys. Karuks, like I said, I definitely could move. Maybe package him and Noel for a better backup center, or him and Rubio for a better backup point guard. Donovan Mitchell is a restricted free agent, along with Conley being an unrestricted free agent. And the Grizzlies want to bring him back. Stop it. I will give Conley all he wants. Oh my god, he's eligible for this Supermax. Do I give Conley the Supermax at 33? F it, I will. I just want to make sure I get him back. I mean, this video isn't going 5 more years, so I can care less about that. All right, so we're going to bring back Conley. Mitchell got a deal from the Lakers. Interesting. So we are obviously going to match that. Noel was a free agent. Interesting. So, yeah, like I said, we're going to need a backup center as well. I would like to bring back Nerlens Noel. Let's see if I can bring all 3 of these guys in. If not, that would be annoying. Yeah, I can't sign Noel. Okay. So another center I could go for is Kenneth Faried. Wouldn't be a terrible option. All right, so we get Kenneth Faried. And like I said, I am going to look to move Karuks and Rubio for a better backup point guard. Okay, never mind. I think I'm going to do this trade. We are going to trade Karuks, Rubio, and Faried for Miles freaking Turner, who's going to be our backup center. Now, we do need a backup point guard. We could look at Seth Curry. I'll offer Seth Curry a deal, and you know what I might do? All right, so now we have Seth Curry. So what I'm going to try to do here is trade Seth Curry, Emmett Williams, and a future first for a backup point guard and hope I can get somebody good. Zaire Smith, Mo Harkless. Nobody's offering me. Hachimura is cool, but I need a point guard, man. Brandon Clark, Frank Kaminsky. I thought that said Neil Akita. I would have done that. All right, not one point guard offer. Nice. All right, I'm going to try to offer Seth Curry and a future first for Jalen Brunson to be our backup point guard, and the Mavericks agree to that. All right, so we're going to see how this rotation will work out. I might change it come playoff time. 32 to Conley, 33 to Mitchell, 28 to Covington, 33 to Harris, 32 to Gobert, and then the bench being Turner, Langford, Brunson, and Green. I'm actually going to swap these minutes real quick, unless Brunson is solid. Actually, Brunson is pretty good, so I'll give Brunson 18 instead. All right, no scoring options, please. So 4-star balanced. Nothing's really changed about the starting 5, so that's obviously expected. Actually, if I go Romeo Langford at the 3, it goes up to 4.5 stars. Huh. What's Romeo Langford's defense? Because I will think about that. If it's pretty good, it's B-. Covington's an A+. So no, I'm going to keep Covington in the starting 5. And then our preseason power ranking is the highest it's been. 5, 2K Sports, 10, and then Mark Spears at 5. Please let me get out of round 2 this year. Please. All right, guys. So we end this season with a 63-19 record. Best it's been so far, because it's definitely been the best bench we've had yet. I honestly don't remember. How did I get Miles Turner again? Who was the guy I traded for Miles Turner? Was it Rubio? I think so. Like, that's crazy. And do we get Coach of the Year? We do in Quinn Snyder. And still, we don't get anybody in the All-NBA team. It's kind of funny. So, I wonder where Kyrie ended up signing. Did he re-sign in Boston? Oh, it doesn't show yet. I'm curious to see that. But we do get Covington and Gobert on All-Defensive Second Team. Love to see that. No rookies, but we are a 1 seed. Let's go. We're taking on the Pelicans once again. They went 40-42 again. Wait, no, that was last season's record. They're pretty good. They got Jackson Hayes. They actually were worse this year. But yeah, Kyrie did stay in Boston. Interesting. Definitely not happening in real life. I guess he's really going to be a Net. After all that time, we all thought he was going to be a Net. Kind of sucks. Just for Knicks fans. But it's really, I'm really excited to see him in Brooklyn. So, Mitchell, 19.5 points, 4 assists. Conley, 18-8. Probably his best season yet with us. Definitely. There's Tobias, 18, 7.5. Langford, Gobert, Turner, Covington, Brunson, Green. You can see that I'm just very excited to get into these playoffs. Points per game, 4th, allowed 1st by a pretty good amount, and then point differential 1st by a pretty good amount. All right, if we do not make it out of round two again, I might lose my mind. Game one, we lose. Game two, we win. Please just go up 2-1. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We're up 3-1. Let's just win in five and get this over with. Whew. All right. We don't get some Zion cheese. Now, we're taking on the Phoenix Suns, who got Kobe White, Devin Booker, Josh Jackson, Isaiah Todd, DeAndre Ayton, Theo Maledon, Mikal Bridges. Cool, cool, cool. So let's see what happens here. They were 44-38 this year. So we won. Oh, my God. We're down 2-0. We're really down 3-0. 3-1.